Hello students, welcome back to the online classes of social studies. We shall continue civics chapter 1, diversity. Today we will learn about diversity of festivals in India. And there are three types of festivals that are celebrated in India. Some are religious festivals, some are based on the regional, and some are national festivals. So festivals are celebrated across our country and they are either related to our religion or maybe our crop celebration when our crop is harvested. Some are related to the seasons and some to commemorate political achievement. Commemorate means to remember some political achievement, like we got the freedom, that is 15th August, Independence Day. Or Indian Constitution, that is also, we got our own rights, that also is celebrated as Republic Day on 26th January. So let us see them one by one. Religion-based festivals. So some festivals are based on religion. Like Hindus celebrate Dussehra, Diwali, Holi. Muslims have Eid ul Zuha, Eid ul Fitr. Christians have Christmas and Easter. Jains have Mahabir Jayanti. Buddhists have Buddha Purnima. Sikh have Guru Nanak Jayanti. And their main festivals. So these are some religion based festival of different religion that you learned. Like you have Dussehra, Diwali of Hindus, Christians celebrate Christmas, and Punjabis or Sikhs celebrate Guru Nanak Jayanti, so on. Next you have regional festivals. Regional festivals are which have been or celebrated in various region. This is because more number of people follow that culture, stay in those areas. So regional means the people staying in that particular area, the more number of people follow the same culture, so they celebrate this festival. For example, Bihu is a festival of Assam. Onam is a festival of Kerala. Pongal is a celebration in Tamil Nadu. Okay, and Baisakhi is in Punjab. So these are regional festivals celebrated in a particular region because more people of that region follow the same culture. Okay. Next we have national festivals. And you know, national festivals are Independence Day, Republic Day. And we celebrate them with great joy, with a lot of pomp and show. Okay. These are organized to commemorate, to remember the birth of independent India and the making of republic by adopting our own constitution. So we celebrate the national festival to remember the freedom that we got and also the making of republic by adopting our constitution. Dance and music. Dances, there are different regions having their own different dances and musics. And in the beginning, dances and musics were performed in the temples. And these dances and musics were connected with the epics. They were depicting the different forms and expressions. And they were related, and some dances were also related rather than the epics with the marriages. When somebody's marriage was there, some musics and songs were sung and some dances were performed to celebrate the birth of a child also. Some dance forms in India are like Kathak is of UP. Okay, Kathakali is in Kerala. Kuchipudi is in Andhra Pradesh. Bharatanatyam is in Tamil Nadu. Manipuri is from Manipur. Bihu in Assam. Lavini is from Maharashtra. Garba is from Gujarat. Bhangra is from Punjab and Ghumar from Rajasthan. So these are types of dances from different regions. So these variety we have in India in dance and music. म्यूजिक पैटर्न्स आर वेरी 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 डिफरेंट. द कर्नाटिक म्यूजिक फाइंड्स इट्स रूट्स इन द सदर्न पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया, वेर एज हिंदुस्तानी म्यूजिक फाइंड्स इट्स ओरिजिन इन द नॉर्दर्न पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया. सो वी हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ म्यूजिक, कर्नाटिक म्यूजिक एंड हिंदुस्तानी. कर्नाटिक म्यूजिक इज रिलेटेड विद द सदर्न पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया एंड हिंदुस्तानी म्यूजिक इज ओरिजिनेटेड फ्रॉम द नॉर्दर्न पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया. There are many other local forms and variation in different parts of India. So we have many other musics in different parts of India. Dresses. If you go to a marriage ceremony, you will find the most people are wearing dresses which they may not wear as normal daily wear. When you go to marriage party and all, you dress up very differently, which you not wear every day. You wear something special. These are worn to depict out customary connections with our origins. So we wear those types of dresses to just show our customs, our origin. The major difference forms of dresses which can be related to region are salwar kameez in Punjab. Like we have different. So if you go to Punjab people, they will be wearing salwar kameez. And if you go to Rajasthan, there they will wear ghagra and kachli and lehenga choli in Gujarat. Lungi will be worn in South India. Kurta pajama in Central India. Dhoti kurta in West Bengal and Northeastern part of the country. So many variations of the same dress can be found in different part of the country. The sari is worn in more than 10 different styles in different parts of country and so in dhoti. So see, sari is worn by in India many people, almost every Indian, but there are different ways of wearing saris. The Maharashtra people, Marathi will wear in different way. In UP they wear different way. In Bengal they wear in different way. In if you go to Orissa they wear in different way. So all will have their own way of wearing the sari. So there is a different way of dressing up in every each state and every region. That is the difference and diversity in India. Food. People from different parts of the country have different taste and different pattern of food and preferences. And these type of different pattern of food is dependent upon what type of food is or the crop is growing in that area. So like in UP and Punjab, it is grown, the wheat is grown, so people eat more of wheat product. And if you go to South, people eat more of the rice product because rice is grown over there more. Okay, so they eat more of like dosa, idli, sambar, vada, etc. And they consume most of the dishes made with the coconut. Fish and spices which are locally produced in that area, so they use it in large quantity there. Okay, if you go to northern state of Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, people here eat more of chapatis rather than rice. Coconut is not common here because it is not grown here, and dal is more used here as it is grown here more. So also variety of vegetables people eat in different parts of different regions. So our food habit depended on the food grain which is grown in that particular area. Arts and paintings. There are different paintings of people varying with the region since the surroundings. Flora and fauna. Flora and fauna means the plants and animals are different, so there are the motifs and themes are also different in the art and paintings, and the choice of color is also different. So if you go to different region, there is different art, different painting, they used different colors. In Rajasthan, there are tendency of using peacock blue and such color, and the themes are more of various. That means valor. Valor means the bravery, strength and legions of kings. They are centered around palaces, nobles, war. Common motifs are elephants, camels. So if you will see Rajasthani painting and all, you will see more of color. You this peacock blue color and green, such colors, green color, peacock blue color And the paintings are more of bravery, some kingly postures, some nobles, war. These things will be shown. In South, more of gold and blue is used. In Southern painting, more gold color and blue color is used. Themes are mostly related with the gods and religious deities. The cow, which is considered as holy animal, is also prominently used motif in Southern paintings. In the North, if we come, the color is used more red and black. Rivers, hills, tea garden are common themes. Spears and boats are commonly used motifs here. So this is about the art and painting also varying in India. In South, different painting. Rajasthan, different painting. In the Northeast, if you go, there is a different painting. Northeast, you have more of red and black color. Red hills are shown, rivers are shown, tea gardens are shown in their themes. So this was for today, children. We have learned today about the art and painting of India. We have learned about the different religions, festivals, different dances, music, the dress up, the food that we eat has variety. Tomorrow we shall continue about the unity that we see around in India. Thank you.